Regarding quitting, as I say, I moved to Florida about 12 years ago and stayed there 7 years. In fact, I joined a group similar to Yahara House called Vincent House, also based on Fountain House, which is a trend in mental health which I recommend if you know someone with a mental illness. In Florida, I managed to quit cold turkey. Then my car broke down and I didn't have the money to fix it. A friend of mine at Vincent House said he could fix it. He said the fuel pump was broken. Anyway, this person, who I knew only socially, began taking everything out of my trunk, then the spare tire, then the carpeting. I watched him start unbolting metal down below, trying to get to the gas tank from above. I watched this going on, him digging deeper and deeper, and throwing everything on the ground. I was pretty nervous, but I didn't know if he knew what he was doing or not. I finally wandered off, found a neighbor, and borrowed a cigarette. By the time I smoked it and came back, he was done, put everything back. It cost less than $5, the price of a fuel filter, only I'd restarted. Since then, I've quit about 5 times, seriously, but the longest was only about 3 days. I get worried, then nervous, then anxious, then I go to the store. I do seem to have better luck with the nicotine substitutes, only not over any real time. I've tried all the different substitutes, including Chantix, but the 2 months in Florida was my longest quit. Regarding Chantix, I didn't really feel the nicotine, and logically I should have been able to quit, only it didn't stop me from lighting them. Are any of you aware that there's a disease called tobacco psychosis? I had a peer in a hospitalization with that. He was usually unusually normal and cogent, but when he would go out and have a cigarette and then come back to OT, he would start drawing spirals on paper saying he was building a time machine. It does occur.
It's the great obsession of every drink alcoholic to control and enjoy his drinking. It doesn't work. And it doesn't work for me. And the only way I can do it is to not pick up every day. And that's the same philosophy and attitude I have to take with smoking. If I think for a second that I can pick up a cigarette, just one or maybe two, and let it go, I'm really deluding myself. That's how I have to do it one day at a time. If I start thinking out here that I gotta, you know, I'm not gonna smoke for 10 more years or for the rest of my life, I'm done. I might as well pick up a cigarette right now. Because if I think like that, I'm not gonna make it. It's like if I have to quit drinking for the rest of my life, I'm done. I'm gonna pick up a drink. My favorite thing was, you know, a Diet Coke and a smoke, or, you know, any kind of alcohol and a smoke. So they're very interconnected for me, but I know that if I don't do it today, if I make the commitment that I won't do it today, I won't do it today. What I did is I cut back on smoking during the week. On the way to school and on the way back, I'd eat fruit. In about 2 weeks, I was able to quit smoking.